I can see you're a little excited about it.
Oh, it's incredibly exciting. I mean,
you like this.
It's not every day, right, that folks get to be on the pioneering edge of a phenomenon that will literally transform something as fundamental as how our kids learn. I don't believe technology by itself really solves any problem, right? I believe it's incredibly
useful. Should you say that out loud?
Yeah.
by itself. I think your boss may be watching.
No, this is actually one of the reasons why he's so excited actually about what's happening is that the way we think about technology and the way that so many folks here think about technology is not as kind of the universal magic pill that you swallow and boom, everything gets better, right?
Yeah.
But as a really powerful aid that in the hands of the right people, right, can drive the creation of new ways of doing things that create huge new benefit for the American people. And so that's the really practical way to think about it. That's the way it really creates benefit. I can't think of a better example of it in action, that philosophy in action, than digital learning.
And I can't think of a better way to sell the idea.
We've been working very hard over the last year, for a long time, but intensely over the last year, with the Alliance for Excellent Education, and talking about the changes that technology can make. And they've been out in the country talking to teachers and school districts and individual schools and parents about this. And yesterday, we introduced legislation, a bill in Congress called Transforming Education Through Technology, which really provides 21st century capabilities to every school in this country.
You know, first, Governor, I just want to thank you and the Alliance for what I think is extraordinarily important leadership. And these are really tough times for school districts. Budgets are very, very tight. We're asking more of teachers. We're asking more of students. The move to the Common Core, I think, is a game changer. But there's nothing easy about it. So as we think about how we work not just harder, can't ask people to work much harder, but how we work smarter, how we utilize technology, not for technology's sake, but as a teaching tool to engage students in their own learning and to empower teachers, which is, again, just an amazing example of what's going on here. Does it make sense to have 100,000 schools do this in isolation or 15,000 school districts do this in isolation? That doesn't make sense.
This idea that Governor Wise has had, this venue, this opportunity to catapult school systems across America into the new reality for teaching and learning, leveraging digital content, the opportunity to get plugged, to plug in at any point, day or night, beyond the last bell or before the first bell, is a reality whose time has come.
For our children to make the most of it and for them to be ready for the 21st century, we need everybody to understand that technology is not just a toy and it's not just about entertaining. Caroline, Helena, and Anne are surrounded by technology on a daily basis, but not so much when they're in school. That has to change. Our students shouldn't step back in time when they walk through the school door. And that's why I'm excited to participate in Digital Learning Day and celebrate the launch of Project 24. Your participation and hard work will bring our classrooms into the 21st century and help us invest in the future of teaching and learning.